table, the first thing we need to do is make sure we're over the center of the point we wish to rotate about, which will be the center of the rotary table. We've created a hole here that we can indicate. First thing we'll do is eyeball it up and make sure with the tool we're roughly over center of our hole, which is over the center of the rotary table. So by eye, we'll get it close, and then we'll add our indicator to the spindle and indicate the hole until it's exactly on center. Once we've indicated the hole so it reads the same all around, we now know we're on center. Set your digital readout to read XY0. And now we can set up our part. Center of our rotary table and part. What we now need to do is move the y-axis so that the edge of the tool will be past the edge of our part. We'll feed our y-axis into the appropriate number, and then we'll engage the rotary table to go around. In this particular case, we have a half-inch diameter cutting tool, and we require a 3/8 radius on our part. So we'll move our tool way out in the y-axis. We'll turn it on, lower down here in the clearance in our fixture, feed into our number. So our number we're going to feed into on the y-axis, keeping x on 0, is the radius of our cutter plus the radius of our part. So we have 3/8 part radius plus a 1/4 inch tool radius. 3/8 and 1/4 is 5/8. Once I reach 5/8, I'm going to lightly lock the y-axis. Our tool should now be just touching the material. We want a full 180 degree arc, so we're going to rotate it from 90 plus 180 to 270 degrees, and then again feed off our part in the y-axis. Once we've reached exactly 270 degrees, we'll unlock the y-axis and feed the tool away. Stop the spindle and we're done our part. We've now made a 3/8 radius into the end of our part.